We can all agree that Elementor helps users make awesome websites. Here are the 6 features that you need to know when using Elementor to make a website look great. While Elementor does give you the power to create complete designs from scratch, you don't always need to do everything yourself, thanks to the Elementor template library. This library includes a bunch of templates that you can insert with just a click. As of Elementor 2.0, these templates now come in 2 formats. These are full page designs that you can import and then tweak as needed. And these are designs for specific sections rather than entire pages. For example, if you just want to drop in a pre-built contact section to an existing layout, blocks can help you do that. Once you have some of your own designs, you can also save them as templates or blocks to easily reuse them later on. With a massive portion of the web's traffic happening on mobile devices nowadays, you need the mobile version of your site to look great. All of the designs that you create with Elementor are automatically responsive. That is, they look good on mobile. If you ever want to see how your design looks on a different device, Elementor lets you quickly launch a preview without leaving the interface. Elementor also takes things further by letting you show or hide individual widgets on certain devices. For example, if you have a huge hero image, you might not want to display that image on the mobile version of your site. Elementor's responsive design controls let you hide it on mobile devices with the click of a toggle. Because page builders eliminate the need for custom code, sometimes you have to sacrifice a little flexibility over where you position elements in order to achieve that simplicity. What's great about Elementor, though, is that it gives you tons of intuitive controls to make sure that you can place every widget section and column exactly where you want it. You can manually set padding and margins for sections, columns, and widgets. Adjust column widths by just dragging the divider between columns. Position widgets vertically within a column or columns within a section. Create a blank space between columns with adjustable column gap. Inline text editing is a convenient method for editing text on your page. Rather than needing to use a pop-up like some other page builders, Elementor lets you just click on the page and start typing. Anyone who has never made a mistake has never tried anything new. As Albert Einstein so kindly tells us, you're probably going to make a mistake. Okay mistakes when you try out new design approaches. If you do mess something up, Elementor makes it easy to undo your mistakes in 2 different ways. First, every single action that you take is logged and can be reverted as needed. Second, every time you save your design, you'll also get a completely new revision that you can revert if needed. These individual actions are cleared when you exit the interface. So it's every single action that you take during a specific design session. Saved revisions are always accessible, though. If you ever need to deactivate Elementor at some point in the future, you can rest easy knowing that it's not going to leave behind a mess of shortcodes like WP Bakery Page Builder or Divi Builder. Instead, Elementor leaves behind a clean code, though you will, of course, lose all the styling. The core Elementor Page Builder plugin is 100% free and open source. But the Elementor team also sells an add-on called Elementor Pro. This add-on gives you lots of helpful functionality. Here are some of the most helpful features. Up until recently, Elementor was always just for your content. You still needed a quality theme sitting underneath it. With this release of Elementor Pro 2.0, though, you can now build your entire theme with the same drag and drop Elementor interface, including your header, footer, and blog post templates. To build your theme, you first select what part of your theme you want to build. Then, you can use the same Elementor interface with the addition of widgets for that type of content to build your layout. For example, if you build the template for your blog post, you'll be able to drag over widgets for the post title, post content, author metadata, etc. Elementor Pro just plain adds new widgets. In addition to giving you more flexibility, these can also help you replace other plugins. For example, Elementor Pro has widgets for forms, including contact forms, sliders, social share buttons, countdown timers, pricing tables, login forms, etc. When you purchase Elementor Pro, you unlock all the templates and blocks in the library. Beyond just getting more, the Pro templates are also usually a bit more detailed and complex. So, it's more a situation of more plus higher quality. Let's look at some more Pro features. Global widgets. Sometimes, you might have a situation where you want to reuse the same element on multiple pages. For example, you might have a contact section that needs to include the same content on every page. Global widgets make this easier by letting you save that widget as a template to reuse on multiple pages. Automatically update every instance of that global widget just by editing it once. If you just want to create basic styled pages, the free version of Elementor should have enough power. In fact, Elementor probably offers the most feature-rich free version of any page builder. With that being said, if you want to use Elementor to actually build out your core website pages, or build your entire website now, thanks to the theme builder, then Elementor Pro is a great option because of the new elements, extra controls, and other functionality. Because the Elementor team made it easy for developers to extend Elementor's functionality, you can also find tons of other helpful Elementor extensions that go beyond the official Elementor Pro add-on. Please let me know what you think about Elementor in the comment section below. Check our playlist for Elementor with even more tutorials and reviews. Hit the like button if you enjoyed this video, and see you in the next one.